at 12:15.
Now on one, Tanya finds that old habits die hard and that some come back to haunt you in Shortland Street.
You already knew that she was married. The only hitch here is that she's married to me, correct?
No.
You are much too good for Chris Warner. What's he got that I haven't got?
Evening all. Now, is this a table for two or can any old mug join it? Won't take long, I promise.
Drink. People have a drink somewhere else. You know how important this is to me.
Okay.
Ladies.
What was that?
I've taken the liberty of ordering us a bottle of Chardonnay. You will join us. Just gives us a chance to get to know each other a bit more.
Actually, Libby and I might head off. Find somewhere with a view.
That is a brilliant idea.
Oh, come on now. Where's the love? After all, we're practically family.
I don't think so, Mark.
Speaking of family, there's someone missing here. Oh, I remember. It wouldn't be fair to leave the wife out of all this fun now, would it, Callum?
Pardon?
Oh, I probably shouldn't have said that.
Did he say wife, Callum?
Did I fail to mention my...
Wife? Yes, you did.
So tell me, Callum, why was it that Justine didn't take your name? Is it just that she's not your old-fashioned type of girl, or was there some other reason?
Justine? Jones. You. And you.
Oops. Nice one, Weston. You got me. And the girls, too.
I told you you didn't know anything about him. What am I supposed to do? Call births, deaths, and marriages before every date?
Given your history.
At least George was honest.
Pardon?
About his wife. He wasn't honest about being gay, but at least I knew he was married from day one.
Well, that's okay then.
And this isn't about George. This is about that lying, smarmy, sleazy creep.
Not talking about me, I hope. You guys left without me.
Yours. Right. I don't know why you thought it would be entertaining to humiliate me like that.
Oh.
I'm not finished yet. I don't know what I have done to deserve such a lack of respect from you. In the future, Mark, do the right thing. Tell me before the date, not during it. And do not take so much pleasure in it. You can go now.
Oh. I was kind of hoping to hang out with Tuns.
I'm sorry, Libby needs me. Shut the door behind you.
Gotcha.
I'm so sorry, Lib. I know how upset you must feel.
Oh, I'm not upset anymore. I'm just angry. Very angry.
Mr. Dipton needs a bed, but he's still waiting to be admitted by the medical registrar. Can you transfer him when that's sorted?
Sure. I'm giving the registrar a call now. Do you want me to remind her about your guy?
Oh, no, thanks. I don't want her to think that I'm hassling her.
So we get a build up here because you're scared of offending someone?
No, it's just that I've already called her once. I'll call her again in half an hour if she's not down. Is that okay with you? Fine, seeing as I'm clearly incapable
Sarah.
Of making...
Can we take this somewhere else? I want to get in before the day starts and make it really clear that you two are not to bring your personal issues into ED.
I forgot.
It was a civil discussion, Tony.
About a trivial matter that certainly didn't warrant the debate you were getting into.
With respect, Tony, I'm running things here. I don't need anyone to tell me how to behave.
Yeah, the other staff might disagree with you there.
Oh, come on. We managed to be civil yesterday.
The nurses and doctors were walking on eggshells waiting for the fireworks to start.
Which they didn't.
And they won't.
No, they won't. Don't make me go to Chris.
Maybe she has a point.
Hey, I'm just trying to keep my nose clean and avoid working nights.
Okay, well, perhaps a strategy might be wise.
Okay.
We both agree to stick to our allocated patient load?
Done. And we agree that we can make our own decisions about our own patients?
Any recall or return patients are seen by the same doctor?
Mm-hmm. And the house surgeons and registrars can choose either of us to consult on their cases.
Okay. We tag each of the patients we're going to take on the computer, and how about I take fractures and trauma? You take females, adolescents and soft tissue injuries.
Yep. I'll stay out of your way and you stay out of mine.
Well, that seems workable to me.
Me too. Triage list? Right, mine, and mine, and ditto.
No, no, except both those category 3 patients need to be seen in the next 10 minutes, doll.
No problem.
Don't you think you're biting off more than you can chew?
Positive.
But they've already been waiting 20
minutes. Yep, so they need to be seen now. So I'd better get on with it.
Last. Could this place be any more out of the way?
I think you'll find that the view's worth it.
Darling, I want to live in the city, not look at it. Plus, I said I wanted a swimming pool.
Ooh, you are in a real mood, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
3 guesses why. You came home at a reasonable hour last night. Either the PA put out without you having to do any of the legwork, or it didn't happen at all. I'm betting on the latter. It's a pity, darling. She was just your type, too. Young, blonde, overenthusiastic.
Mm-hmm. You can't seriously be considering this place. I mean, look at this kitchen. Talk about your 70s flashback.
Yeah, it might not be pretty, but it's sturdy.
Sweetheart, I took the job at Shortland Street so we wouldn't have to settle for the blandness of the burbs.
It's not settling. So it's not all Bauhaus. I like it.
I was only trying to help get us out of the financial crap.
There's a very good school, only 1 bus ride away.
But you had to make things difficult, didn't you? Go and bonk one of my colleagues.
Oh, he was my colleague first. What do you call last night? You hypocrite.
And you don't think you deserved a little payback? You're right. Nothing happened. I was never going to go there with her, all right? I do have some standards.
Oh, I see. You chose the blonde cliche just to wind me up.
Like I'm going to bonk a typist. Senior nurse is as far as I'd sink.
So, what do we think about this place? Yes? No? Maybe?
Juzzy, it's suburbia. Progressive dinners, garage sales, neighbourhood watch. This is not our sort of fun.
I want the kids to have a home. A proper one.
What do they say in real estate? That it's the woman who buys the home?
Something like that.
So there's really no point in me arguing, is there?
Okay, Mr. Patel, we'll pop you into a cubicle and Dr. Potts will see you again as soon as he's free. Oh, Craig, could you see Mr. Patel for me?
Sure.
Radiologist found an undetected avulsion fracture in his ankle.
Righto. Mr. Patel, I'm Craig Valentine.
Hello.
Where were you seen yesterday?
Here.
Oh.
By Sarah.
Right. Well, we'll need to get some treatment underway, but first I'm going to take a quick look at you, okay?
That's the Indian guy from yesterday.
Yes, Mr. Patel.
He's my patient.
Well, strictly speaking, yes.
Excuse me. Hi, sorry to keep you waiting, Mr. Patel. Thank you, Craig. We're good now.
Yeah, I've got this one, Sarah.
Yeah, but this is my recall patient.
I'm sure that you have others to see.